Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Dan and this is PixelFix. In today's code review, we're going to look at an admin panel for a small blog. The application is also an open source project I found on GitHub. I'll leave a link in the description to that repo. Now, the admin panel is pretty straightforward. You can perform various CRUD operations on a blog post. The admin panel has also the ability to view a post via an ajax call, which then displays the post within a pop-up modal. Okay, so let's jump in and look at the routes file. Firstly, I have to say a good attempt has been made in order to follow naming conventions when naming methods within the controllers. Secondly, the actual route names are also fairly decent. Something that could be improved is structuring the actual routes like these, but we will get to that in a sec. Now, something else that could be improved upon is consistency. If you look at some of the controllers, you can see, for instance, this controller is called using the full namespace, and the other controllers are just called by the controller name and uses the import at the top. Another inconsistency I found was in the actual method names. This method name uses camel case, and this method name is written in snake case. Now, the correct way, if you follow naming conventions and standards, would be the camel case. So just make sure you are consistent throughout your application. Okay, so the first method I want to look at is the post update method. So let's just make some space so we can see it a little bit better. Okay, so the way we're going to rewrite this route is like so. Firstly, the method should be patch and not post, because we are updating information, we're not creating information. Secondly, when you update a resource, you don't need to say in the actual route that this is going to be an update route, because that information is captured in the route type and your controller method. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll comment this one out, and this one we'll place a comment to say that this is the correct way for structuring a route. Now, the last thing is we change our variable in the route from ID to post. This is so we can utilize route model binding. And if we look at the actual method, we can now accept our post as a typed variable to utilize this route model binding. Now we can remove this line of code because we don't need to manually find the post anymore. Now the next thing we're going to do is change this line of code. Instead of assigning the slug every time we update the model in the controller, we're going to move this functionality into the model itself by overwriting the boot method within the model. We'll say that every time this model is busy updating, we want to take the title and slugify it and then assign it to the slug property. This way we can now remove this line of code, and we don't need to worry ever again within our application to set the slug manually whenever this model gets updated. Okay, so now we can actually go ahead and remove it. Now the next thing we can do is, instead of assigning these variables individually to the properties of the post and then calling the save method, we can rather take the validated information from the request and then pass it straight into the update method of the post model, like so. And then basically we can remove all these lines of code. The only thing we need to double check is in the post model to make sure that our title, writer ID, and description is within the fillable property, which it is. And now, as you can see, our controller method is only two lines long and it works exactly the same. Okay, so the next thing I want to look at is the ajax call, where we get the post information. So normally I would place a method for a vanity route like this in its own controller, but this application is small enough so we can utilize the post controller in this case. This will be a once-off thing, but I will still change the route like so. So instead of just calling the route ajax view, I would place it under the post so we can utilize the route model binding. Also, the post or the method should be get instead of post. And then we can call our controller method show ajax instead of just view ajax. Okay, so let's go ahead and refactor the actual method. Okay, so in our post controller, we can rename it to show ajax. We can also accept the post as a typed variable so we can utilize route model binding. And now we can go ahead and remove these two lines of code. Okay, so the next thing I would do is, instead of formatting the post comments beforehand, I'll just return this as a resource and let the front end handle the formatting. Okay, so we can basically remove all these lines of code and replace it by returning a post resource. And then we can clean up our method. We're returning a post resource, and we can remove this because it's not being used anymore. And then we can just double check within our post resource that it returns the title, the description, and the comments as before. Okay, before we move on to the last section, please remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notifications. Now, in the last section, we're going to look at the method for adding the actual comment. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is update and restructure the actual route so we can utilize route model binding and the relationship on the post model. We will also rename the method to store as well as the route name. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the actual method. Well, firstly, we need to rename this to store instead of create. Secondly, we can accept our post now as a typed variable so we can utilize route model binding. Secondly, we can remove this line of code because the post ID is not being used at all. And we're not finding the post manually anymore because we utilize route model binding. And now instead of creating the comment manually by setting all the properties, we can call the, or we can use the post and then rely on the comments relationship. And then we can call the create method on it. And then we can pass in the user ID and the comment as the required fields within the array. Now, instead of assigning the request information to an input variable, we can simply pass it straight in like so. It's the user ID. And in the comment, we can say the request comment like so. And then we can go ahead and remove this line of code as well as the comment create statement. All right, and then we can just go ahead and clean this up a little bit, add spaces where there's supposed to be spaces. Now, something else that should be done in this method is validation. Currently, there are no validation being done on the input fields, but we've covered form validation in a lot of previous code reviews, so I'm not going to do another one in this code review. And that's it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notifications. Until the next episode, see you later.